Let's study a very important concept of electric pressure on a charged metal surface. We know that in case of a metal body, when we supply some charge to it, due to mutual repulsion, all the charges will spread on the outer surface of the body. And in the section of electrostatics, we have already discussed that it is distributed in such a way that on the zones of metal surface where its radius of curvature is less, the charge density is more. And on relatively flat surfaces or broader surfaces, charge density is less. Now anyway, in this situation, we can say every charge on the surface is being repelled by the remaining charges of the body in outward direction. Because we know that electric field always exists in the direction perpendicular or normal to the surface. So every portion of this metal body will experience an outward electric pressure due to the mutual repulsion of charges. This pressure we call electric pressure. So we can write down that due to mutual repulsion of charges on a body surface, every part of body experiences an outward pressure which is called electric pressure. Now we are going to study about this electric pressure and to mathematically calculate its value. Let us consider a small segment, say this segment is AB, which is of area DS on the surface of this body. And say if the charge density at the location of this segment is sigma, then we can simply say the charge on element AB is this charge dQ can be written as sigma dS. Now, if we just consider the section AB, then due to the charge on the section AB, if we consider two points, one outside the body and one inside the body, just outward and inward to the section AB, on this point, which we can term as X, the electric field due to the section AB is an outward direction which can be written as E1. And on this point Y, which is inside the body, the electric field E1 will be in opposite direction. And the magnitude we can take same as X and Y are just in close vicinity of the section AB and symmetric to it. Now if we just ignore this section AB and we consider the remaining body. See, due to remaining body, the electric field at point X and Y is E2. Then obviously due to the remaining body, this E2 will be in outward direction at both the points, because X and Y are almost coinciding points for the remaining body as these are in close vicinity of section AB. Here we can say net electric field at point X is, in this situation, net electric field at point X we can write as EX, and this can be written as E1 plus E2, which is a net electric field outside the body in the direction away from the surface. And this E1 plus E2 can be written as sigma by epsilon naught, which we already discussed in previous sections, that just outside a metal body, net electric field is given by sigma by epsilon naught, where sigma is the local surface charge density on the body. And if we talk about net electric field at point Y is, you can directly state electric field at Y will be E1 minus E2, as these two are in opposite direction. And inside a metal body, we know that net electric field inside a body is always zero, or we can say charge is distributed on the body in such a way that at every interior point electric field becomes zero. So this must be zero. And from these two points, we are getting an important information that E1 is equals to E2. and this is equals to sigma by 2 epsilon naught, which is a very useful information for us. And always remember here that we can write down a note. Just always keep it in mind. Just outside, a charged metal surface at any point, electric field due to a local elemental region is half of the total electric field at the point. Here you can see the net electric field at a point just outside a metal surface is sigma by epsilon naught, and that due to a local elemental region, the charges on the local elemental region is sigma by 2 epsilon naught. And here you can see that we have derived this relation qualitatively in a direct manner. So it is applicable for all kind of cases. This is quite useful. And now using this electric field, we can find out the pressure experienced by the surface on the elemental section AB. Now we can calculate the force on element AB is, this force we can write as DF, which can be written as DQ multiplied by E2. Here DQ is the charge of the element AB and E2 is the electric field at the location of AB due to remaining body. Here we are not considering E1 because E1 was the electric field due to the charge DQ only on AB. So we know that a self electric field never exert force on its own charges. Now in this situation, this DF we can write as DQ multiplied by sigma by 2 epsilon naught, and DQ we can write as sigma DS. So this will be sigma square by 2 epsilon naught into DS. And if we find out the pressure on section AB is, this we term as electric pressure. And this electric pressure we can write as DF upon DS because the force is acting in the normal direction. DS is the area, so there is a force per unit area acting on it, which is sigma square by 2 epsilon naught, which is quite an important result. You just need to keep it in your mind always that electric pressure on a charged metal surface is given by sigma square by 2 epsilon naught, where sigma is the surface charge density at the local point on the surface. Here we can say if electric field, net electric field just outside the metal surface is E. We know well that just outside the metal surface electric field is sigma by epsilon naught. This implies we can write that surface charge density is given as epsilon naught multiplied by E. So we can also write electric pressure in terms of net electric field. Electric pressure on surface can also be given as, we know it is sigma square by 2 epsilon naught, it is 1 by 2 epsilon naught multiplied by epsilon naught E whole square. And it can be written as half epsilon naught E square, which is also the result of electric pressure. You can use either of these results are quite useful. But the first one is more important because in majority of cases we need to calculate electric pressure in terms of surface charge density.